Russia says the possible leakage of missile technologies from Ukraine to North Korea may be discussed at relevant international organizations. A spokesperson for Russia's foreign ministry made the comments on Russian TV on Friday, reiterating that the recent findings on North Korea's ICBM launch last month linked to Ukrainian technology, not Russian. Citing classified assessments by U.S. intelligence agencies, the New York Times reported this week that North Korea's successful ICBM test was made possible by black market purchases of rocket engines probably from a Ukrainian factory with historical ties to Russia's missile program. North Korea is stressing that its nuclear weapons development is not aimed at any other country other than the United States. However, there is a caveat. Those countries won't be threatened as long as they refrain from siding with what Pyongyang calls Washington's anti-North Korea military movements. In a commentary in the North's state-run Nodong Shinmun on Saturday, the regime claims its nuclear development is to deter the U.S.'s reckless moves to start a nuclear war. The paper adds that North Korea's weapons development has been transparent, unlike Washington's weapons that it says are poised for use in an invasion. Watchers say the remarks suggest Pyongyang is feeling particularly isolated on the international stage.
It was just this past Monday when U.S. President Donald Trump asked Lighthizer to consider launching a formal investigation. The White House is relying on a 1974 law which predates the World Trade Organization in settling trade disputes. The U.S. Trade Representative says the investigation will examine whether China's policies harm American intellectual property rights, innovation, or technology development. Earlier this week, Beijing pushed back, saying the WTO is the place to resolve these disputes.
Trade measures taken by any member of the World Trade Organization should abide by the rules of the WTO. We have said repeatedly before that as China and the United States are increasingly interconnected with their interests closely entwined with each other, a trade war will get them nowhere, nor will it have a winner, but only leads to a lose-lose situation.
I don't think the United States is going to be a dangerous country, but Donald Trump is certainly a very dangerous president. What has happened domestically in terms of Charlottesville? Charlottesville shows the divide in the country is extreme and both sides have automatic weapons. Things will happen and can happen. And what he's done in the last couple of days is even worse. On the trade issue with China, I think, number one, nobody said anything about 301 in the announcement, including his entire cabinet and including Donald Trump himself in the announcement on the executive order. It is the beginnings of an executive order to begin a study of what may be. So I'm looking at a year of studies and nothing will happen. You're absolutely right about this is diverting attention from his serious domestic problems. He also has to throw some bones at his base. Namely, oh, we're doing something about China.
Yes, I'm going to jump in very quickly. I think the point here, though, is that Trump's bark is worse than his bite in this, in that it is the investigation to decide whether there should be an investigation of China.
Exactly.
So, in fact, he's backing off from his initial threat. So I think, in a sense, if we look at it from a U.S.-China trade relations perspective, this is actually a positive for the relationship, but I think it demonstrates the weakness of the Trump administration currently.
バリバリバリ。 Pyongyang still evading sanctions. Exports of banned items said to be worth $270 million since February. North Korea continues to make money by skirting UN Security Council resolutions, with its exports of banned commodities generating at least $270 million since February, according to a classified report of a United Nations panel obtained by Kyodo News. After China's suspension of coal imports from the north in February, Pyongyang has been rerouting coal to other member states including Malaysia and Vietnam, the report said. The UN midterm report was compiled by a panel of experts, made up of representatives from the Security Council's five permanent members, Britain, China, France, Russia and the United States, as well as from Japan, South Korea and South Africa. It is expected to be officially released soon. The DPRK continued to violate sectoral sanctions through the export of almost all of the commodities prohibited in the resolutions, generating at least $270 million in revenue, the documents said. Referring to the country's official name, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, it has also made shipments through third countries, thus deliberately using indirect channels to evade sanctions. The combined effects of lax enforcement of existing sanctions and Pyongyang's evolving evasion techniques are seen as undermining the goals of getting the North to abandon all weapons of mass destruction and put a stop to its nuclear and ballistic missile programs, it said. The report mentioned the widespread presence of North Koreans in Africa and the Middle East, particularly in Syria, and their suspected involvement in prohibited activities such as trade in surface-to-air missile systems. Also referenced was Malaysia's report in March to an international body regarding the use of a chemical warfare agent, VX, in the alleged assassination of Kim Jong-nam, the half-brother of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. He died as a result of a suspected attack with nerve gas in the Kuala Lumpur International Airport on February 13. Multiple rounds of sanctions have been imposed on Pyongyang since 2006, when it conducted its first underground nuclear test. The North Korean government has continued to carry out banned activities, which also include launching ballistic missiles, ever since. Under the latest Security Council resolution of August 5, measures were taken in an attempt to restrict the flow of funds for the North's nuclear program by slashing its $3 billion in annual export revenue by a third. Bans are now in place on exports of North Korean coal, iron, iron ore, lead, lead ore and seafood. Since March 2, 2016, North Korea has registered nearly 70 vessels, a 44% increase over 18 months. At the same time, however, many ships have been moved from its international trading fleet to its domestic fleet, an unusual development given that the nation straddles two coasts and its ships must travel through international waters. It is believed that by using the domestic category, North Korea could conceal critical vessel recognition data and circumvent international maritime law, the report says. The panel is also looking into other forms of revenue, including the North's leasing of its embassy properties for commercial purposes in countries such as Bulgaria, Germany, Poland and Romania.